2018 Mitsubishi Outlander FEV First Drive, nailing the sweet spot. Santa Catalina Island, California. For years now, while the Mitsubishi brand has languished here in the U.S., other parts of the world have been enjoying the Outlander FEV. It's Europe's best-selling plug-in hybrid, and Mitsubishi has been improving on it over the years, testing it, refining the technology and punishing the vehicle in competitions like the Baja Portilegre 500 and the Asia Cross Country Rally. Now, as electric vehicles begin to gain greater acceptance, and as Mitsu turns its brand around, it will finally offer the Outlander FEV in America at the end of this year. As Mitsubishi prepares to launch the Outlander FEV stateside, we had the rare opportunity to drive it across the interior of Santa Catalina Island, off the coast of Los Angeles, to test it out on some rugged, scenic roads. Sitting inside the Outlander FEV, we were actually pleased with the interior. It was simple and clean, and the plastics didn't feel especially cheap. Sure, it wasn't the thoughtful design or plush touched points of the other available plug-in crossovers on the market, but the Outlander FEV also doesn't share the same price tag. We definitely found it to be more attractive and appealing than the inside of, say, a Chevrolet Equinox. If you were expecting a pile of hot garbage from Mitsubishi, you're way off. When we popped open the rear lift gate to take a look, we found our near-ideal tailgating vehicle. In the rear cargo area was a ton of space, a large speaker, cup holders and a standard three-prong outlet, perfect for plugging in a slow cooker, blender, or any other appliance you could find useful at a football game or campsite. Later, when we would take a break from our drive at Catalina Island's Shark Harbor, we'd be treated to a smoothie prepared in a blender plugged into that AC outlet. If you happen to use all 12 kilowatt hours of energy, the gas engine will fire up to serve as a generator. The Toyota 4Runner may have had the party mode button, but the Outlander FEV would be our pick for the stadium parking lot. As we passed through a gate at the edge of the town of Avalon and headed up a dirt road across the interior of Catalina Island, we were quickly impressed with the way the Outlander FEV handled the rocky, dusty trails from which most drivers are normally prohibited. The steering feel was light but communicative, and we were really able to tell what was going on between the front wheels and the rugged surface beneath them. For green drivers, having three driver selectable modes available, along with various levels of regeneration, gives a sense of control. Mitsubishi took the geeky route. But for a normal customer, they just want to drive this vehicle like any other vehicle, they don't need to. It remained composed in the corners, its low center of gravity and super all-wheel control, SAWC, four-wheel drive system minimizing roll and providing stability. It took a fair amount of effort to get this thing to give up any traction, and we weren't keen on attracting the ire of conservancy rangers by flagrantly breaking the island's 25-mile-per-hour speed limit on blind corners to do so. The Outlander FEV borrows those fantastic paddle shifters we loved so much in the Lancer Revolution. They serve a different purpose here, though, as this plug-in only uses a single, fixed reduction gear. Instead, the paddles adjust the strength of the regenerative braking. There are five levels of regen, six if you count the zero regen setting, allowing you to choose between coasting and something near one pedal driving. While full regen won't bring you to a complete stop, it will slow you down significantly. We found the varied range of regeneration especially useful when descending a steep, bumpy hill.